You're almost done. You still need to replace a couple of materials that are meant to be reflective. Continue working on your scene or open the file environment-mat-final.max if you need to catch up. In the Slate Material Editor, create a new arc and design material. Double-click it and set its preset to Satin Metal. Use a medium gray diffuse color to darken it slightly. Wire it to material ID number 4 to replace the old gray standard material. Render the scene to see the results. The render is a bit grainy, but you can increase the quality after you're done with testing. Create one more arc and design material. Use the glass thin geometry preset and wire it to replace the material currently used in ID number 3. Render again. The glass around the counters looks much more convincing now. It is at the same time transparent and reflective of objects nearby and the environment you defined earlier. You are encouraged to replace the remaining standard materials with arc and design counterparts. Try a matte or pearl finish to replace the white color on the walls. Give it an off-white tint at the diffuse level if you want. When you're happy with the results, you can increase the image quality to remove all the grainy noise in the final render. For that, use the Image Precision slider. The higher you go, the better the quality, but the longer the rendering time. When you're done, save your file. In the next and final movie of the series, you add animated pedestrians to liven up the scene around the booth.